Okay, these are hot, so these, you know, are always better to let them rest and cool off. But I just wanted to show you what they look like once they come out. They do get firmer as they sit in the refrigerator. And I'm trying not to burn my fingers here. So I did get quite a few sausages, and I showed you if you wanted to make hamburgers, you know, you can stack them one on top of the other, and then you can steam them in one large roll. I think you've seen me do it already. See, I could save the aluminum paper if I do it when it's cold, but a little hot to handle. Okay. Oh, they're so good. You gotta love vegan food, guys. So I'm gonna just put this to cool off, and then I'm gonna show you. There we go, nice and cold. Remember, gluten-free sausages, you should refrigerate them first and get them nice and firm. And then you can simply throw them on the grill, in a pan, however you want. Over the weekend, we were up north, we just sliced it and we laid it into, put on top of some bread with some lettuce and some avocado, and it was good. Just cold, like sliced meat on bread. So it's really good. But here we go, it cuts beautiful. There's the inside, you get to see the beets. There's all kinds of delicious stuff in here. My God, I think these are one of my favorites. So, there you go. You can still make sausages. And not using any, you don't have to use any of the vital wheat gluten whatsoever. And look how beautiful they cut. Delicious. So, guess what, guys? I'll see you in my next video.
For more videos like this, make sure to subscribe to Connie's RAWsome Kitchen, give it a thumbs up, and share it with your friends.